Veit. We are about to do Happy Hour Live, and he is the new official, I would say, producer. Maybe not co-host, because I like doing shows by myself sometimes, but you definitely will be the co-host in the same time. You know what I mean, Jellybean?
I'm here.
I'm very caffeinated on coffee. All right, let me place this on me. This is going to be very dizzy when I upload this to YouTube.
All right, fans, let us know what you think of this. I'm very excited to get Kyle on here. I know him because he's a fan of the Bone, but he's not like a bandwagoner that just kisses my ass. He's very honest with me and very real.
Very annoying, you could say. You just listen to my damn advice.
Yeah, dude. Well, it's... Nah.
The following thoughts on Happy Hour do not represent Cox Media Group or its sponsoring. Anything you hear may and will be used against you. Thank you. Voted as best local podcast in Tampa Bay by the Creative Loafing. You're listening to Hoppe Hour. Tweet Hoppe at Ryan Hoppe Radio. Email him, ryan@hopperadio.com, and give him a nice sexy Snapchat at Hoppe Radio.
Are you feeling classy today? Sit down for a glass of wine and listen to Hoppe Hour.
You're tuned in to Hoppe Hour, an hour where Hoppe rants about something. Sit back and listen in. Hoppe Hour is on now. Hoppe Hour is on now.
What up? What is happening? This is Hoppe Hour. I am your host, Ryan Hoppe, and I've been debating, because I don't want to force a co-host, you know what I mean? But I've been wanting to get a guy in here who can produce a show, who can help me book guests. So one of my good friends that I have met in town, Kyle Vita's live. What's up, pimp?
What's going on, buddy?
How's it going, dude? How pumped are you to be here?
Dude, I'm stoked, man. A little nervous, not gonna lie, but I'm here, and I'm liking it.
All right. You can tweet at me, at Ryan Hoppe Radio, but it's the tradition we have to live by. Let that beat drop. It's not too hard to get into contact with me. I promise. It's not rocket science. All you have to do is tweet at me, at Ryan Hoppe Radio. If you're listening live via Spreaker online or via the app on Google Play or the iPhone shop, just chat me live and I will be sure to see it in real time. Email me, ryan@hopperadio.com. Shout out to radio legend Kevin Matthews for coming on Hoppe Hour today. That was very surreal and very badass, so I appreciate Kevin coming on. This week, we have a full slate of guests. From 99.7, The Blitz in Columbus, from the top-rated Loper and Randy in the Morning Show, Jeremy Loper will be on Hoppe Hour on Wednesday. One of the funniest comedians here in the Tampa Bay area, and we are loaded with comedy down here. Wouldn't you agree, Kyle?
Oh, yeah, man. Yeah, Tampa, you got a little bit of everything down here.
Damn right. Comedian Law Smith will be on the show. And Thursday, a guest that I can't believe even said yes. You've heard him on Opie and Jimmy, and he has his own show on Sirius Radio, on Opie Radio. The very funny Dan Soder will be on as well, and I'm booking other guests that will be on very soon. But I want to get your take on this, Kyle. Before I even talk about that dirtbag, that piece of crap, that cretin, that evil bastard, known as Jared Fogle, what's it like being a parent? Because I imagine... before you have kids, you hate pedophiles. You think they're sick. You immediately lose your appetite when you hear about them on the radio or hear audio about them talking about kids, you know. But once you have kids, how much does that change your world?
You have no idea, man. Before I had my, you know, my first one, my daughter, Addison, I was kind of crazy doing my own thing. And you have her and your whole world changed, man.
How does the world change? Like, in what way?
Because you don't think about yourself anymore, man. It's not, hey, you know, what can I do to better me, or, you know, or what can I do to make my, you know, I don't even know how to explain it. All you think about is that little girl, you know, or that little boy, whichever it may be.
Yeah.
So it's nuts. It's, no matter what you're doing throughout the day, they're first in your mind. You know, their safety comes before anything else. you know, and having any, even thinking about a pedophile.
Be wrestling. What would you do, dude, if a pedophile even sent a Facebook message to your kid, even though it's five, let's just say in a scenario, what would you do if someone like Jared Fogle were to begin talking dirty or something as sickening as that?
See, I'm not the normal, you know, law-abiding citizen parent. Yeah, you know, I'm a Marine, you know, military.
Ooh,
parent.
Watch out!
I will kill you. It was in the story. You'll be gone. If I find it before the police do, the police will never find you. You're gone. You know, I can get rid of a body real quick. I know exactly how to do it. I already have a plan. Don't even worry about that.
What would... Actually, I don't want to get your tip because I'm not trying to get turned into the feds. So, here's my thing. I seem to think that we kind of overlook what pedophiles do and what type of human beings they are because it's so sickening. And the fact that... We love checking out hot chicks. Heterosexuals do. Homosexuals love checking out guys. Lesbians love checking out girls. This and that. That's what you're attracted to. But we seem to overlook that pedophiles go to a playground and they are immediately turned on and they immediately like what they see. And what I don't get is pedophiles sometimes get lesser jail time than drug addicts, and we seem to just give them short terms. Jared Fogle could get out of jail, Kyle, in 5 years, and he probably will, because he has the money of a celebrity.
See, what you need to do to a guy like that, go ahead, let the freaking community pay for a sex change for him, make him into a female, give him female downstairs parts, throw him into an all-male prison. Have fun.
Not even that. No. Don't even give him prison time. Here's what you should do.
Let him spend 5-12 years getting raped every day of his life and kill him.
I don't even think you should even let him live. I don't get why we give these guys rights. They want to have sex with kids. I know it's not something we like to think about. I'm sorry. But they want to have sex with underage kids that don't even know what sex is. To me, that's so inhuman, that's so gross, that's so awful. They should be killed on the spot.
It's almost hard to even comprehend them.
I know, dude. It's disgusting, dude.
It is disgusting. It makes you want to throw up as soon as you think about it.
When I heard the Jared Fogle audio, which we'll get to, dude, I couldn't eat for a few hours. Like, I lost my appetite, dude.
You don't really think about how real the whole thing is, and kind of like, oh, well, maybe he looked at child porn or something, until you hear that audio and hear his plans and hear him. Dude, it's bad.
What I loved was the people that tried to defend him. They would say things like...
By love, you mean hate it, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, but there are people that tried to defend him. They're like, well, it was a 16-year-old girl. She's pretty close to being the legal age, this and that.
Listen to that audio.
But when we hear the audio, it's just funny, and we will have things to say about that. So this is from Dr. Phil. Of course, he would be the one to scoop it up. Here is some audio. It will give you chills. If you have any kids listening, or you're a guy or girl that has a very small heart and you can't handle things that are gross, I would say don't listen, even though I want you to. Because a lot of shows are afraid to play the audio because it's not friendly and it's weird. This is life. Not everything is about Kim Kardashian's fat ass. All right, here's the clip.
Noticed when we were at the middle school was the children were so eager to talk with him and excited to be around a famous person. And I believe he used that to his advantage.
What's up, Kyle?
What's up, man?
Were you going to say something?
No.
Oh, well, I actually have a point with that, too. I love the fact that they immediately said that they felt like they could relate to him and they looked up to him. Because I feel like pedophiles, one of the reasons why they're attracted to kids is the fact that they feel like they are kids. That's why they can relate to them, is they either got touched as a kid and they never fully grown up, or they never fit in, so they want to be a kid at heart. That's why they relate so well, is because they feel like they're in the mind of a kid. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I got you. That's what they say, you know. The scary part about it is you never... It's not the stereotypical guy standing in a corner being loomy. Like, the guys who are the serial rapists and stuff like that are guys that, you know, look normal, that are average. When you talk to them, you seeing Jared Fogle on a freaking Subway commercial, you never think, dude, that guy's a freaking pedophile. Negative. You know,
if you saw Jerry Sandusky now, that one's a surprise. He's weird.
So there's some weird ones, but the most of them are normal people, even ones that you know, are the rapists of full-grown females or males, whichever way. They're always normal people, you know, usually likable people, and that's how they get into you. That's how they start, you know, get that friendship and that bond going, because they're average, normal people. You know, it lets them get close enough to do what they're going to do, and, you know, it's freaking terrible, man.
But when you hear this audio, it's not normal whatsoever.
That's on a different level. I don't even understand how that girl stayed on the phone with them.
Because you're trying to record it to bring in evidence.
I know, but if I'm sitting there talking to this guy or on the phone with him and he's talking about my own children, talking about...
Yeah. What it reminded me of was Mel Gibson's girl who recorded him yelling drunk. The audio seemed kind of fake in the fact that she was trying to get evidence. So she was really good at asking follow-up things that brought out the dirt in him, if that makes sense. All right, back to the clip. This is from Dr. Phil.
I'm concerned that through his work and all that, that's how he was getting access to kids. And you talked about this.
We're doing good.
Let's listen to this.
You must go crazy with your travels because you get to go into all the different schools. You have things like that. I'm sure you have a lot of stories. I want you to tell me some of them so that, I don't know, it's just, I like to...
Yeah, especially some of the middle school that was the middle school and then girls are starting to, you know?
Yeah.
Because you know how much I love the, you know, I love your what's that?
Well, you know, kids are maturing faster nowadays.
Oh, I know, which I love. And that's why I think it's wonderful with you is that you're able to get in early. You know, you can totally, win them over, which is what I love.
What I love is my type of girl is any girl that's attracted to me, but I love a girl that works out, that wears yoga pants, and that's classy. That's my thing. But he immediately knows what turns him on. It's not a girl at the club. It's not a guy at the gym. It's kids in middle school. He has it picked out.
It's disgusting, man.
Like, I love going to middle schools because they're kind of half grown up, but they're not.
That's disgusting. It is freaking disgusting. You can hear in her voice, though, that she is disgusted. You know, that she's struggling with the whole thing.
But you know what I mean? It's like we pick our category. You might like blondes with big boobs and a fat ass. I like a mix of anything. But he has it specifically down. He's like, love middle school kids because they're sort of grown up. Like, that's why pedophiles should not be alive, is they specifically know what they are attracted to, and these kids don't know what they're getting into. And the worst part about it is these kids are ruined for life because of dirtbags, scumbags like Jared Fogle. But we're going to let them be in cells by themselves because they don't get along with general population. Think about it. They want to have sex with kids, and their lives are ruined forever because of a selfish creep like Jared Fogle. Think about that. I'm not saying once they're found guilty, Kyle, kill them. I'm just kind of saying we seem to be lenient. Like, just because he didn't have sex with as many victims as Jerry Sandusky, we're not giving him 500 years in jail. Why did Jerry get so many years in jail? I know it happened over 30 years, but just because it was Jared and he's a famous celebrity,
we're giving him less time.
He's got money, bro. He's got money.
It doesn't matter. That is what's so sickening. The money doesn't matter. He wants to have sex with kids. You would think that would be something, but these scumbag lawyers and judges get it done.
It's the kind of screw up you can't fix, man. It's something that is never going to change. It'll never change. I don't understand what
it's they. It's just money, but these are kids' lives that are ruined. They want to have sex with kids. God, it gets me mad. All right, back to the clip. This is from Dr. Phil, and it's a girl that got audio as she talked to Jared Fogle on the phone, and he was talking dirty about kids. It's absolutely sickening.
You like that?
Am I not close enough to the mic?
Tell me,
speak
will
up?
You tell me how to
both.
Yeah, just talk to them, just get to know them, just everything, and just, you know, do a little touchy-feely things with them, you know, make them feel good. And it's a little more touchy-feely, a little more touchy-feely, a little more touchy-feely.
Wait, so what do you like, touchy-feely? Like, can you imagine that? You're, like, rubbing their back. You're a good kid, Johnny. Don't let them make fun of you. Like, that is what we overlook. They know how to run the game. Guys that are normal, guys that are heterosexual, Kyle, they know what to say to girls to take them home. The version for a pedophile is you're enticing them by being nice. That is what is so sick about them, is they know how to run the game.
Exactly. They know how to run a game on an 11-year-old and on a 10-year-old. It blows my mind. You know, he's done it, obviously, so many times that he has that down pat. How long would it take you to talk, okay, well, maybe not you, to talk to girls, but normal people, it takes you know, 15, 20 times, you know, trying to figure out how to talk to a female, how to talk to girls, and get that game right. He has that done already. You know, he's got his game pinpointed for children. And it's disgusting, like I said before.
Touchy and feely. Yeah,
he knows what does, you know, what works for him. And
he's a pickup artist of kids.
It's disgusting.
I know, but we owe 5 years in jail, whatever.
Because he has money. Like I said, make him into a female. Pay for the sex change. Make him into a female. Throw him into a prison. Let him get raped for the next 12 years of his life.
All right. Back to the clip.
That kind of stuff.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Okay.
I think that would be amazing.
I love how he has a rank for kids. Like, my thing is, my rank is the classier, the better. You have a good vibe. You seem friendly. You seem like you'd be fun with. His is middle school, you know, like when they're at the playground, you know, wearing their Abercrombie shirts. Like, he has it picked out. He knows what age it is, dude. It's, oh my God. This is what I love, is shows were afraid to play this audio. It's like, if we don't expose this and we don't talk about pedophilia, it's never going to go away. I know it's not a fun topic. I know nobody wants to talk about pedophiles. I get that, but you have to.
The sad thing is, man, it's never going to go away. It's one of those things that will always be there, but it's the fact you need to catch it early. You need to catch the people early and lock them up and keep them in jail. No matter how much money they have,
yeah,
you need to keep them in jail.
All right, back to the clip.
Pick
your mic up a little bit.
No,
talking to it.
And they're up there at the jail, right with that?
What's
that? Need to find out how, if they'd be all right with that.
No, they definitely are right with that. They're very much exploring, and, you know.
Couples sometimes, sex gets boring. So they go to, like, a sex shop, you get lube, you get a dildo, you get outfits, and you spice it up. Maybe you get a cage, BDM, whatever. That's what he wants to do with kids. You spice it up. It gets boring for him. Like, what do you think, dude? Like,
man,
I'm speechless.
It's hard to even stomach that kind of stuff, man. Listening to him. You know, this is a hard subject to talk about. And
it shouldn't be. We should just be able to talk about it. I know it's not easy.
Talk about it freely. Just, I guess when you have kids, it makes you want to puke. Even just thinking, you know, listening to him talk about this stuff is insane.
Someone on Periscope just said, kill that pig. I agree. There's no reason to be alive. Because here's the thing. Oh, I love it, Kyle. People go, but all you need is just give them some classes, give them some therapy. They'll be okay. It never works.
It never gets untaught. That kind of screwed up never goes away.
And not just that.
Ever.
Kyle.
Yeah.
Please have sex with a guy tomorrow and never have sex with a girl again, okay?
No.
Yeah. You can't force what you are attracted to, especially when it's that demented, that evil, that sick in the head. That's what I don't get about these people that defend pedophiles. The only people that defend pedophiles are the ones that are friends or related to them. You can't change what you are attracted to. And when it's that sick in the head, and it's that demented, and it's that far gone, there's no way to fix it. You can't just say, Jared, go bang out a hot 24-year-old blonde. They're going to be attracted to middle schoolers. This is what I don't get.
It's kids. He has a wife. He has kids.
She was ugly. So
is she ugly? I've never seen.
Most pedophiles, when they have wives, they kind of just do it just so that people don't think that they're pedophiles. So they just go, oh yeah, I'll marry Susie, but they never really care about the look. What?
Like a cover up gay guy.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
All right. Back to the clip.
Just matter of getting them on your side, you know.
And that's what I'm just curious.
Getting them on your side. What the hell? I'm getting mad. I can't even run the board. Getting them on your side. That means you're enticing them, you're twisting your head, and you're confusing them because they're kids, they're innocent, they're juvenile. He's running the game.
Well, he says it. They're the most influenced. That's what he said a little bit earlier. They will experiment a little more because they're confused. You don't know who you are as a person, you know, at that point in your life. And he sees that, and he's targeting that to benefit himself. And it's disgusting.
But yeah, he's got money. He's a celebrity. Give him 5 years. Whatever. Ugh. Screw you.
How to do that? Just be friendly to them?
Yeah, just be friendly to them. Just do what you normally would do, baby. Because that's what you're so friendly anyway.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then we can just sort of go from there. We take it, and I think it's all case by case. You know, there's no right way, wrong way, whatever, you know?
He's so caught up in himself that he doesn't even realize how uncomfortable this girl sounds. You hear that? You hear
and he can't even get the words out. He's so speechless and probably so turned on, he's at a loss of words. So he's so
caught up in himself. You can hear in that girl's voice that she is, you know, bouncing around questions. She's not getting into anything. Oh, does that turn you on? Oh, well, I'm intrigued. Like, she's not saying, no. Heck no, it doesn't turn you on. Like, are you kidding me? But he's so wrapped up in himself, and like you said, he's all turned on and worked up. He can't see, hey, guess what? You're being freaking set up. This girl thinks you're disgusting.
Because
you know what I mean?
Pedophiles aren't all there in the head, and he must have the IQ of a brain-dead cat. If you didn't think you're being set up by the way she's talking.
I know. Listen to it. Go ahead, listen to it, and it's so blatantly obvious that she's setting him up.
Like, let's hear this. All right, back to the clip.
Well, he's thought about this a lot.
You think, Dr. Phil?
He's got a plan, he's got a technique, he's got skills, and you can tell he's done this over and over and over.
Can we just start calling him Dr. Obvious? Can we just start calling him Dr. Obvious?
Yeah, like that was the most obvious thing. Of course he has skills, he's a pedophile!
Like he's done it over and over again, yeah. He's got it.
Why is he even a doctor? There's like reports that he's sort of a doctor, but he's a product of Oprah.
Yeah.
Piece of dirt. God, I hate him. But I had to play his audio because I wanted to expose this creepy piece of dirt pedophile. All right, back to the clip.
Yes. At one point he called me and was telling me about a 6-year-old little girl and that he was flying over to see her. And from the way the conversation was going, it sounded as though the parents were okay with this. And I...
Of course they're okay with it. He's acting normal. You think he's trustworthy. He's Jared from Subway. That's why I don't get there's not more outrage about how much jail time he got. He used the authority of being a celebrity, and you never expect it. It's not like it was Herbert from Family Guy, where it's an obvious pedophile. That's what's so sickening.
I don't give a crap who you are. You are not going to come. I don't give a freaking crap if it's the president. Freaking Mr. Obama. Hey there, Kyle. I want to come down and hang out with your daughter, Addison.
And have you not there?
Hell no.
What no. Dumbass parents.
What are you talking about? I mean, who's the parents in that situation? Like, yeah, sure, come on.
Yeah, just take my kid for a weekend at some exotic resort. Whatever.
It's a Subway guy. It's all right. Yeah.
I don't care if it was Mother Teresa in the 80s. I'm not letting my kid go anywhere.
At that point, the parents should be locked up, too. You're an idiot. You should also go to jail.
They should at least be charged.
Yes.
What about when your kids get older, summer camps maybe, Girl Scouts, Boy Scouts, would you let them go to camp?
Oh, I'll let them go to camp, but I'm going to be, you know, throughout my daughter's, my son's life, I'm going to be open about them the whole time. I don't want them to be scared to tell me anything. So I want them, like, that's going to be open. If they come back and, hey, freaking doctor, or freaking this instructor touched me here. Like, oh, okay, well, what's their address? I'm going to kill them.
Someone just had a good point. People seem to forget that Michael Jackson had sleepovers with Jesus juice and kids, whatever.
What is Jesus juice?
That's what he called it. That was the wine that he gave him. It was called Jesus juice.
Oh, that sounds like rape in a bottle.
Thanks for making pedophilia sort of funny. Oh my God, you're killing me. All right, back to the clip.
I told them what was going on, but they couldn't do anything because he wouldn't give me a name. He wouldn't give me the place where he was going to. And all I can envision is him going to this six-year-old girl and violating, changing her life forever.
Exactly. He is having sex or performing sexual acts on a kid. Every time she has sex, even if she goes through therapy, and even if she gets quote-unquote cleansed, anytime anything happens, she will always think about that subway creep getting involved with her. That's why I don't care. We want to just not think about it. We need to, because pedophilia will never, ever be cured. You're never going to get rid of it fully. But if we have more exposure about it, then we talk about it more. If we give these guys longer sentences, we have fewer of them on the road, out in public.
You know, the morning show here actually made a good point. It's not like a pedophilia, whatever, isn't a normal thing anyways. But it isn't like a normal, you know, scenario. This is going to be one of those things for years. They're going to come back to this. So even as these kids start getting better and things are getting better, in 5 years, they're going to be, hey, remember that subway guy, blah, blah, blah. And there, it's all back to him. So all that healing and stuff they're trying to get to is going to make it that much harder because he's such a high-profile person. You know?
And not just that. But the thing is, when he gets out of jail in 2025 or 2020, whenever he gets out, it's going to be such old news, dude. Like, think about it. We are so desensitized to the fact that Michael Jackson did things with kids.
He's still going to have enough money when he gets out that he's going to be able to just disappear somewhere.
And
or
not
he's
just
going to be somewhere where nobody's going to know him. Even if he goes to Thailand or whatever, just because he's changing location doesn't mean he's going to change his personality and who he is. He's going to go right back to what he was doing, right back to raping kids and everything else. And I don't understand. I don't give a crap how much money you have. How is that okay? I'm hoping a jury doesn't give a crap about a plea deal and will just throw him in jail for the rest of his life.
Yeah, I mean, any pedophile, I don't care how small of an act, even though there really isn't a ranking of an act, but how many charges you have. If you have one charge and you have one video, or you're Jerry Sandusky, or you're Gacy or Dahmer in the 90s and 80s, or you're Jared Fogle, every single pedophile is equal. Because you want to have sex with kids, you don't care, you're sick in the head, you don't mind ruining their lives. We need to wake up. We need to shaken up and either put them to death once they're found guilty or put them in jail for the rest of their lives because they will contribute nothing to society. They will do nothing but just be creeps. Even if they don't act on it, all they have to do is drive by a playground and get turned on. They are going to be so tempted. Half the time when these pedophiles get released, they act up again because you're turned on.
You don't even keep him in jail forever because that's, okay, now you keep him in jail for the rest
just
of his life.
Just kill him.
Now
get rid of him.
You are paying for him to be there. They're taking our tax and everything else, and I'm paying to keep him alive in prison.
But whatever. He sold sandwiches. Whatever. Give him rights.
Next on Hoppe Hour.
Anonymous is going to begin revealing the names of the alleged Ku Klux Klan members. And I will explain to you why this is ridiculous. Not the fact that they're exposing the KKK and that the names are going to come out there, but why this is a scam. I will leave you intrigued with that note between me. It's not hard. Ryan, Hoppe Radio, if you're listening via the Spreaker app, just chat me. Or if you're listening on live, chat me. And if you're listening on demand and you want to send me something that's more than 140 characters, ryan@hoppyradio.com. We will be right back on Hoppe Hour after this on your computer or tablet. Hang on.
Hoppe Hour.
Song or commercial? I have one for the company that makes me detailed. Anonymous. We're gonna play one more song. What is that like? Not getting that order.
What's up? This is Ryan Hoppe from Hoppe Hour. And I have a very special shout out
to one of the sponsors of this award-winning podcast. Nicholas Seymour from Duluth, Minnesota, is the owner of Soli's Graphics, which is a badass company that will make you decals. You can buy Happy Hour decals. It's not too hard. For just $4, you can support this award-winning podcast while supporting small business here in America. Or maybe you have a band, a company, a freelancing project, and you want to have your logo made into a nice, badass decal. Nick is down for making deals, and he's very good at negotiating. If you want to get into contact with Nick, it's not hard. Trust me. He will answer your call real quick, and he is one of the nicest guys I know. His number is 330-419-0691. That is 330-419-0691. Or you can send him an email, solesdesign@gmail.com. That is solesdesign@gmail.com. And to check out Happy Hour Decals for just $4, go to tinyurl.com/happyhourdecal. It is tinyurl.com/happyhourdecal. And when you talk to my guy, Nick, just say that Ryan Hoppe sent you, and he will give you a badass deal. Trust my word, pimps. Nick Seymour of Soli's Graphics is the best around.
It's time to turn Hoppe on. It's time to turn Hoppe on. It's time to turn Hoppe on.
All right, welcome back to Hoppe Hour. I am your host, Ryan
Hoppe. We have so much to get into between me and Ryan Hoppe Radio. Let me know what you think of my last rant about that dirtbag pedophile known as Jared Fogle. And you're getting a lot of love on the Twitter machine and on Periscope when it comes to my good friend Kyle Veit sitting in live on the show. How do you think you've done so far, dude?
I don't know, man. I'm liking it. I think I did good.
I'm really digging the vibe, man. I feel like we're doing a very good job gelling. Like, it doesn't feel like this is your first show you've ever done.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think we've done no prep before this at all. Just kind of sit down, hey, here we go. Let's do
Wait, what's the word prep? We had literally nothing. I just loaded up the Jared Fogle audio. You were saying to me how I need to have more balls around women. And that's it.
I mean, that's a very valid statement, by the way. I mean, just take my advice, take a little bit of advice here and there.
Without saying names and without getting into it. Give me some advice, because your advice was a little controversial. No,
okay, all right. So we go showing myself. He's showing me around the radio station.
No, in general.
Oh, okay.
What am I doing wrong? Not even that incident. What am I doing wrong?
You need balls. I mean, you need to be straightforward. Don't dance around or anything else. Girls like guys that are straightforward. You got to read the girl. That's kind of where you're going to be lacking the most. You have to see a woman and be able to read what she wants and play to that.
Do girls like to teach guys things, or do you need to go in there knowing everything?
Oh, no, dude. It depends on the girl. That definitely depends on the girl. You go in there and play that cute virgin, you know, whatever type thing. Some girls are dick. Dude will tear you up. And it'll happen.
Will they be like a freak in a bedroom?
I mean, they're going to try to walk you through it. I mean, I don't know.
Lessons and homework?
I mean, you go to, you know, some websites, you get all the lessons you want.
My friend said you better have knowledge. Don't go in there expecting the girl to teach you.
Oh, no. No, he's wrong.
Why? What's the craziest thing a broad's ever taught you, or a girl? I feel like a pig saying that.
Well, I'm happily married, so...
Before the days of being married, what did your wife teach you? Come on. Like, it wasn't like you had sex for the first time on the honeymoon with your wife. You obviously were sleeping with women before that. So what's some of the craziest things the girls ever taught you?
I mean...
Don't hold back. Get the hell out of here. Oh, stop. You're acting like your wife's going to listen and divorce you. Stop it.
I mean, she's definitely going to listen. She's definitely going to listen. But I don't know. As far as teaching me, I've always kind of been the one that leads. I love leading and getting in there and... Girls will definitely explain to you what they want whenever you're going below the belt. They will walk you through that, like, to a point. If they're not happy, man, I'm like, you need to go left. You need to go right. Come up a little bit. Do this. There you go.
Sort of like a manual. Right.
Oh, yeah, dude. They'll play you like a freaking analog stick, man.
What's the craziest thing you've ever done?
As far as?
Just with a girl in general. Eiffel Tower, DP.
Never DP.
That's a little too close.
Eiffel Towered, we've done that. I mean, craziest thing is probably, you know, on deployment, going out on a mission, having a female with you. That's a little exciting.
So, being in the Army with a girl?
Well, not in the Army, in the Marine.
Well, being in the Marines with a girl was what turned you on?
No, not even that. It's whenever, you know, being deployed, being out on a mission, you know, having, you know, convoys, because females usually don't go outside the wire for whatever reason, like normal infantry stuff, but they still do go out for, like, convoys and stuff like that. And having a female with you out there,
yeah.
Well, you know, I could be getting shot out here in about 30 seconds, but I don't care because I'm with her. You know what I mean?
Were you ever, like, a guy that would pull in girls while you're in the Marines? Like, be honest. When you would go to bars, would you name drop, I'm in the Marines?
Oh, dude. It's so easy. It's so easy. It is ridiculous. You drop that, and like, wait, you're a what? And as they're sliding their panties off, they're slowly moving closer to you.
I can see you being the dude that just name drops the hell out of it.
Dude, that's what I'm trying to tell you. Let me, I've had experience with this. Let me help you.
Do I just need to go up to girls and just be like, I work in radio? Or how do you approach it, Kyle? If you were Ryan Hoppe, how would you approach it? When you're in downtown St. Pete or Ybor City or any city in general.
You need to start at one of the events, the 1025 The Bone events, or, either with, like, Mike Calfa Show or something being there with the, when they're doing Pitbull Toddler. Start there and just say, hey, I'm Ryan Hoppe. They're going to know who you are. They obviously listen to the show. They're going to know who you are. That already gets you in. All right.
Yeah.
Then play off. Yeah, you say, okay, I'm not a virgin. I stuck me in a couple times. I get you. No, scratch that. Play the I'm the virgin card. I want you to take it. Blah, blah. You know, play that aspect of it. And girls will eat that up, dude. I'm telling you.
So you think girls will find it adorable if I say that I'm a virgin?
You do, because you have this little, like, small child aspect to you. And I think
I really do. It's really bizarre. I can't grow facial hair. I'm
You're
awkward.
7 foot tall, a 7 foot tall child. I mean, it's really. It's,
what are some of the things that make me a child?
I mean, just that goofy laugh you get going on with freaking everything. Like you said, you're how old? You grow zero facial hair?
22.
I mean, the way you carry yourself and have that diddy bop walk going.
That's because of my back. It's because I have scoliosis. I can't handle that, dude. I'm sorry.
No, it's not a bad thing. Use it to your advantage. That's what you got to do is figure out yourself and how to play yourself and present yourself to the female, you know, to the woman. Sorry for saying female. I don't mean to offend anybody. You know, it's just a military thing, I guess.
Why would they be offended by that? I'm not sure, dude.
I don't know. I'm a lady. I'm a woman. I just call them like a female. They're a label. I guess I don't know. And maybe nobody's offended. I don't know. I'm just covering my ground. Hitting the bases, all right?
Exactly, dude. I need you to go with me to downtown St. Pete. Maybe we can meet up with some listeners.
You need me to go with you about four doors down. That's where you need to go.
You're the worst. All right, it says here via the Huffington Post. Before I even get to it, I kind of like having a co-host. I'm going to do happy hours by myself because sometimes I need to explode. It's making it a lot easier.
I think, you know, this is going to do a lot better as a show rather than a rant. You know, you still need your rants, but maybe make your rants part of the show. Like you said, I'm going to end up being your producer. I'm your official producer. You guys need to look for me. I'll probably make a Facebook tonight. It's going to be probably Kyle or Hoppe Radio Kyle. And you guys need to come to me as fans with stuff that you want, stuff that you want to be on the show. I'll find content.
Make a Twitter.
I don't really know how to do Twitter. Never been on it.
Make one that says Hoppe Hour Kyle or something.
Okay, well, I'll do both. There'll be a Facebook out there. There'll be a Twitter out there. You know, look for it either tonight or tomorrow. You know, go ahead and start adding me. And people you want on the show, let me know. Obviously, don't do freaking, I don't know, Ben Affleck. Don't be, you know, jackass. Freaking somebody.
Can you get Ben Carson? No, Celtic got that, which is going
to
be good.
You want me to get a presidential candidate?
I'm kidding.
Do you understand this is my first radio show ever? But I'll go for it. I mean, I'm down. I'll shoot for the stars.
Someone just said that you're bringing a lot to the table and it's making it funny, so I'm digging that.
Let's do it. Let's keep it going.
All right. Here's what it says via the Huffington Post. It says, Anonymous begins revealing information about alleged Ku Klux Klan members. But before I even get to it, here's my thing. Yeah. It was good when they exposed these scumbag cheaters that cheated on their wives via Ashley Madison and ruined families. But this is a bad principle that we are going through in 2015. Just because the anonymous groups don't agree with the KKK or the cheaters doesn't mean it's a good thing that they are able to break in and get their information. Because think about it this way. If they are able to break into Ashley Madison, which is supposed to be that really private website, if they are able to break in and figure out who the pussies are behind the white jackets, they can break into anything. I'm sick of people saying, oh, Anonymous is heroes. Oh, we should look up to them. No, because if they can break into two identities and two aliases, cheaters and the KKK, which are supposed to be so notorious for being anonymous, if Anonymous can figure them out, they can get anything.
Well, they're putting the stuff out for the police officers. It was a while back whenever
they're all... Oh, they're heroes. Look up to them.
Yeah,
oh, stop it.
Police brutality, whatever came out. They were blasting the police officers' addresses, families. Like, why? Okay, I agree. Actually, I don't agree at all. But I can see where you disagree with something, whatever. You want to blast them. That's fine. If you really want to go after that one guy, go talk to him. Do your thing face to face. Do not put his family in jeopardy. Why should his family have to pay for something that he did if it was stupid? You know, and that's obviously your own opinion.
I just think they're pussies that hide behind a keyboard. They would never do this. It's just the principle of the matter. That's my problem with it.
I see them being a room full of, 300, 400 plus pounders with some long hair and glasses and typing away on a keyboard. They have nothing better to do with their lives except for, put innocent people on blast.
Basically, you know? Reddit.com. All right, it says here, last week... You love how I did that transition? Last week, a group identifying itself as the online hacktivists. Oh, screw you. You're nothing but a bunch of pussies that watch too much porn and have no lives. By no means should you ever call yourselves hacktivists, you bitches. And this is anonymous. They vowed to release contact info, identifying 1,000 members of the KKK, timed a year after the specific targeting of the KKK in the wake of the Ferguson, Missouri protests. On Monday, the group followed through, publishing its first batch of information, a list of 57 phone numbers and 23 email addresses. That's my problem. They're pussies that are hiding behind the keyboard. What's your address? What's your social security number? Jeffrey, or whatever your name is. That is the problem with the matter. See, they're hiding behind the keyboard.
It's not even that, man. They get to pick and choose what they go after. I mean, you don't say, okay, yeah, the whatever that happened and whatever, those freaking things. What about the craziness that happened in Baltimore? Whenever they went and started freaking destroying their own city, burning everything down, okay, why don't you blast the freaking, what is it, Black Panthers out? Why does it gotta be, the white activists, whatever? I mean, why do you get to pick and choose who's right and who's wrong in this situation? You know what I'm talking about?
Oh, I know exactly what you're saying. Like, why are we calling them activists if they're only picking and choosing what they want? Be fair and square then, you pussies!
Exactly, exactly. You need fairness across the board. You want to play that devil's advocate? Go ahead, but do it with everybody across the board.
They must have the worst security on Ashley Madison or the KKK headquarters if Anonymous is able to break in. Or they must be geniuses. I feel like every member of Anonymous must just have plain Asperger's where they're just good at hacking, because there's something wrong with you. If you spend the time of day you are given to expose other people when we don't know who you are because you're an antisocial bitch ass that would never do it to their face because the KKK would burn you alive or the cheaters on Ashley Madison would beat your ass to the ground, you pussies.
That's what you need. Is you need another hacker, a normal, you know, a normal hacker that even a normal person that has the capabilities to do it. Go ahead and find them, expose them, put their addresses out there, see how quick they stop.
Just before the group released the emails and members, a Twitter user named Amp attacks. Woo, you're a tough guy, bro.
Like I said, 300 plus pounds, glasses, long hair, semi.
Or they have the body shape of a string cheese. They're skinny little twigs that anybody could beat up. They have gained attention for targeting websites operated by the KKK. I feel like that must just be boring-ass WordPress websites if you're able to break in that fast. Like, if you're a group like the KKK, I feel like you should make sure that the website's pretty good so that people don't break in, bud.
Since when does the KKK have a website? I wasn't aware of this.
They must have anonymous websites, you know what I mean?
I know. Like, why do you need it? You have your little cult or whatever that you do, have some phone numbers, you're good.
Wouldn't you want to be off the grid?
You go, hey, check out our homepage. Check us out on Twitter, KKK, whatever.
Join our newsletter.
I mean, what's with the website? Why do they have their numbers and everything else on their on a website? I don't understand.
Like, why are you on a message board? Or you have some, like, social media account?
Freaking AOL chat room. We don't like your con around here, boy. Like, what?
Like, back in 2007 when everybody had an AIM bio, when you would highlight the name and it would show all the, like, pixels in that, there was just, like, anti-black people. Pieces of dirt.
I don't understand it.
And I don't want people to think that I'm defending cheaters, the KKK, because people that don't like other people that have different colored skin are unhappy schmucks that don't like themselves, and people that cheat on their wives are pussies that can't admit that they need a divorce and they wouldn't want to go through the child support, so they just cheat on their wife. But the principle of the matter is, if they can hack into these anonymous groups like the KKK and Ashley Madison, who in their wildest dreams thought they'd be able to ever expose them? If they can expose that, they can expose any of us. What if one of these anonymous guys is one of our enemies? They could easily expose things. We've said things on Facebook or via text that we would regret and we would want nobody to ever see. What if they were to expose Cox Media or FedEx and all your emails? What's preventing them? They're anonymous. You don't know what they're going to do next.
That's when the government needs to have, you know, some kind of say in this and figuring out who they are.
Why can't they break into the government? What's preventing them?
I'm sure they can. Once they start getting those top secret files there, that's when the government will take charge. Like, whoa. You know, we got to figure out something to stop these guys. They put too much time and effort into stopping counterterrorism and stopping, you know, the other countries getting our information, you know, with the secret and top secret and all that classification. As soon as they start going into that and dipping into that, the government will put a stop to it. Right
what
now,
about,
they don't care.
What if, like, some presidential candidate's a part of the KKK, like Donald Trump or something?
We're going to find out.
That would be hilarious. Or some celebrity that everybody loved, like Ben Affleck or something, where it's just like a mutual actor that nobody has a problem with.
Ben Carson. Like, what?
Just like that old skit from the Chappelle Show.
Yeah. I know what you're talking about. Did you hear what he just called us?
All right, it says here, this is what Anonymous said, and the way he's talking, he's saying it as if he's doing us a service. And he's somebody we should look up to, and that he's kind of the martyr for the internet.
Even though he's a pussy, that his only weapon he has is the keyboard, because he has no social skills, and if it wasn't for the internet, he would be nothing in life. Here's what he said.
I worked for 9 days to gather and verify all the info that was gathered before its release.
So you worked for 9 days. The 9 days you were given in life, you're going to get more, obviously, because you're not dead, but you wasted 9 days to uncover the KKK.
You know what that tells me? That tells me you live with your mother. That means you have no job. You have nothing to do for
maybe
9 days.
Maybe welfare, or you live off the government?
Well, he probably does live off the government, live off welfare, but he also lives with his mom. or whatever, or his sister, or his aunt, or his grandparents. Maybe his grandparents.
Probably someone just said, Anonymous are a bunch of criminal punks. Nobody cares about the KKK. Exactly, they're not really doing anything anymore. Yeah, they're scumbag racists, but it's not like the 1920s.
Yeah.
We're not in Boardwalk Empire era anymore. Get the hell out of here. Right, it says here, and I'm not going to do that voice because I can't handle it. I got the info from several KKK websites when I hacked them and was able to dump their database. I went through many emails that was signed up with these sites. Why are you on the websites, you idiots? I'm actually not surprised that the KKK has websites because you must have a low IQ of 70 if you hate black people and you're in the KKK in 2015. So scratch that. I'm not surprised that they have websites where they gather together because they're brain dead idiots.
A little story to throw in there. Back when me and my wife got my first apartment, I'm Kyle, my wife named Kylie, and I think it was her parents or her parents.
Yeah.
There's these little hand towels that have caves. Sewn into them. So we put them, not even thinking, we put them up in the bathroom right above the toilet on the little rail. But so there was three of them, threw them all up there. And one of my buddies came out of the bathroom like, dude, you guys trying to tell us something? Like, what are you talking about? Go look at your bathroom and realize KKK was across the top of the bathroom. Like, oh, all right, go ahead, take one of those down. That's my bad.
Oh, man. I can't imagine how you just see that and you immediately take it down, freaking out.
Especially if it's not, like, your house. You go to your buddy's house, he's there taking a leak, look in front of you, and there's KKK on the wall. Like, all right, that's the side of him I know.
I'm just saying it here. They say that there's a potential that a senator might be on there, and he already knows about it. And, of course, they're denying it, but I would assume that Anonymous is more powerful than a senator, and it's most likely true. Can you imagine being that senator? You must be freaking out.
Yeah, he's freaking out. That's the thing about Anonymous is nobody knows who they are, so they have nothing to prove or nothing to hide. They don't answer to anybody. So if they say he's on there, there's nothing. I mean, they might, you never know that. They might have a hidden agenda behind, blasting him out. But until you know that, I mean, they're just doing what they see. They're throwing out what they see.
I got nothing more to say about these punks. It gets me so mad. It's just, we're in this era where you can hide behind your keyboard and say what you want. I've had people say mean things about me online, but the two radio shows I've worked for, the one in Cleveland and here at the Bowen, which I've never been happier, anytime anybody ever comes up to me in public, I've never had them say such mean things that they say on sites like Reddit or message boards, because when you hide behind a keyboard, you're nothing more than a keyboard killer or a keyboard warrior, where you have the social skills of the turd that my cat dropped today in the litter box. You're never going to make it in life, so you live vicariously through a radio show, or you live vicariously through being anonymous and being these warriors. So that's the problem we have in 2015, is that this is actually a thing, and it's only going to get worse.
Yeah, the thing, people encourage it. They're giving, iPads and tablets to five-year-olds, starting them, three to 5 years old. It's insane. It's insane giving, starting them out that. So they're going to, get risen up, get raised, through that social media life and through those keyboards. And through those tablets and everything else.
I promise you, I know I say this a lot, and I know you're probably sick of hearing it, but this movie, this clip I'm about to play, Idiocracy, it's really coming to life.
I heard that he doesn't even have a tattoo.
I know. Have you seen this?
And I'm off. You've got to be shitting me.
No.
But check this out, man. Judge should be like, guilty.
Where the whole world's retarded. It's on HBO Go.
What are you objectifying on?
Come on, just get me on the stand.
Okay. Your Honor?
We're about to wrap up.
I object that this guy also broke my apartment this year. Yeah. You know what else? I object that he's not going to have any money to pay me after he pays
best part.
All the money he stole from the hospital.
And I object.
And I object that he interrupted me while
is about to end. But first, it's time for last call.
Wait, what is it? I don't know if you heard or you didn't hear. What time is it?
First, it's time for last call.
You like those drops? You take the voice?
I see it. Who's doing that voice stuff for you?
This guy named Lewis 2 Live. I interned for him in Chicago. He does a dance show called Dance Factory Radio. He's got that very soothing voice, like this drop. Turn Hoppe on. And he does the closing segments where you go, Hoppe Hour, and you have the explosion.
It makes me like want to do, every time I hear, like, I want to do my official radio voice. Welcome to Hoppe Hour. Like, you know what I mean? Every time I hear, I want to do it.
Someone asked, who is the guest? It is the new official, I guess, producer of Hoppe Isle, of Hoppe Hour, Kyle Veit. There you go. You're pretty much the co-host now.
Maybe a co-host. We'll see on the days that I can do it. A couple days a week, we'll try to do this co-host thing.
We're getting nothing but compliments online, so that's a good thing.
The days that I can do it. The days that you're free away from.
Yeah, my schedule is very bizarre. Like, it's weird.
I'm thinking, though, like I said, I'll have the two accounts up tonight. We got to figure out. I think you guys are going to like the show platform more than the rant platform quite a bit better.
Someone said, give me a co-host gig. I mean, you can call in. You can sit in. I'm not trying to have it be a free-for-all where anybody comes in, but if you have a good point, I'll let you come in.
I really want to work towards getting it and where we can get live callers, Joe. I think that's where a lot of people that want to, you know, say something to the show or get us, because that will even help us, you know, keep going.
We would just need someone to answer the phones, because I'm not trying to have, like...
I can handle that. But how the hardest part is getting it done every night, you know, is... Because we have to be on the same time every night for people to know to call. You know what I mean? We're not over air.
Yeah, it's a very good point. All right, tweet at me, at Ryan Hoppe Radio. Go to Google Play or the iPhone shop. Search up Hoppe Radio. You can listen to my show anywhere in the world. I don't care if you're in Auckland, New Zealand, Gary, Indiana, or Tampa Bay. You can listen anywhere in the world. You can also listen to all 27 of my interviews, including the one with radio legend Kevin Matthews. That's up there. And you can listen to all my rants. And when I'm doing a show live, you can chat me. I'm very proud of the app, so download it. Go to the newly updated hopperadio.com. It's not as, like, clunky and it's not as messy. It's much more cleaned up. But my guy, Brandon Langley, a fan of the bone, is going to help me. And he's going to make it even better. But check it out for now. Hopperadio.com. Tweet me, at Ryan Hoppe Radio. Like Kyle said, he's going to have things like Hoppe Hour Kyle online.
Look for it on Facebook, Hoppe Hour Kyle, and on Twitter, Hoppe Hour Kyle. I'll make sure I'll grab both.
And if you want to send him ideas, shoot it that way. I will be sure to promote his account. Also, email me, ryan@hopperadio.com. Coming up this week, comedian Law Smith, one of the funniest comedians here in the Tampa Bay area. And there are a lot of comedians. He is coming on Wednesday. From the Loper and Randy show in Columbus on 99.7 The Blitz, Loper will be on. And Thursday, you have heard him on Opie and Jimmy, on Sirius XM Radio, on Opie Radio. Yes, that Opie and Jimmy show. You know the one? Yeah. Dan Soder will be on, and I am very honored about that. So, that and more. Kyle, I thought this was a pretty good show, dude. I liked how it went.
I'm digging it, bro. I'm digging it.
I wasn't sure, but I liked your... attitude, man. There's a lot of people that jump on the bandwagon. It's kind of annoying, but I'm digging your vibe, man.
Yeah, I've been trying to push for it for a little bit. I mean, you kind of fought me on it, but now that you gave in, I mean...
Basically. You bitch. All right, this has been Hoppe Hour. I'm Ryan Hoppe.
I'm Kyle V.
Peace out. That was good, dude. Yeah, you're pumped up.
What?
Hoppe Hour. This is an official broadcast of Hoppe Radio.
For more info, check out
HoppeRadio.com and HoppiesWorld.com.
There's just $200 here, Nappy.
Serious? I love this show.
Yes. Are you still on?
Appreciate it, bro. I appreciate the kind words. We will be back very soon.